Hello children, how are you all? Today I am going to continue with the same lesson, that is medieval India and the political transitions. So in the last class we have seen about the Qutbuddin Aibak and the Iltutmish. Today I am going to start with the Razia Sultan. Do you know who is Razia Sultan? Razia Sultana is the daughter of the Iltutmish. So Iltutmish son Rukubuddin Feroz was incapable. Do you know what you mean by incapable, incompetent? Incapable or incompetent means maybe he was not suitable, he was not intelligent person, or he don't have any qualities to become a sultan. So as Rukubuddin Feroz was incompetent, his daughter Razia Begum became the successor of Iltutmish, who ascended the throne of the Iltutmish, that is Razia Begum. After becoming Sultana, Razia Begum came to known as Razia Sultana. So Razia Sultana, she was the first woman to ascend throne of Delhi Sultanate. Who was the first woman to ascend the throne of Delhi Sultanate? That is Razia Sultana was the first woman to ascend the throne of Delhi Sultanate, and she earned the title that is Sultana. And what she used to do? She used to participate in battles as dress up like a man, and she established rule from Sindh to Bengal, and some of the officials, that is provincial officials. Do you know what you mean by the provincial officers? Provincial officers are nothing but the area officers who were unable to tolerate her rule. What they did? They revolted against her and killed her. So this is about the Razia Sultan. So after Razia Sultana, Ghiyasuddin Balban. So this Ghiyasuddin Balban is a slave of Iltutmish. Ghiyasuddin Balban, that is Balban, was a slave of Iltutmish and had been a part of Turkish slaves groups. He was a part of the Turkish slave groups, and due to his loyalty, intelligence and good quality, he was appointed with the post of Amir-e-Shikar. Who appointed the post of Amir-e-Shikar? That is Balban. Turkish sardars, the slaves, supported Balban during the political emergencies after the death of Razia Sultana. And after the death of Razia Sultana, these all the Turkish sardars, what they did? They supported Balban to become a Sultan of Delhi. After becoming Sultan of Delhi, this Balban, he controlled the misrule of disobedient of the Turkish sardars. That means the Balban had come to know what this Turkish sardars were doing in his kingdom, in his provincial area. So he got the information and he tried to control the misrule and the disobedience of the Turkish rule. But later what he did? He defeated the Turkish sardars, their evil group. And Balban stopped the attack of the Mongolians and enforced peace and order in his kingdom. And Balban, he wore the Persian style dress, and he declared himself that I am a representative of a god. Do you know what you mean by representative? Representative means what? Leader, messenger of the god. And declared himself that I am a representative of God, and enforced in his whole kingdom, that is a monarchy form of a government. Do you know what you mean by monarchy form of government? Where the kings and queens used to rule. So that kind of a government is called as a monarchy form of a government. And what he did with the help of the military, he rebuilt with the support of the military generals. He rebuilt his army with the support of the military generals and all. And to stop the attack of Mongolians, he built the India. Who? Balbar. Balbar, what he did? He again he rebuilt his army with the support of the military generals, and to stop the attack of the Mongolians and all, he constructed the forts around the borders of the northwestern India. And what happened? And Balbuddin became the successor. After him, the successor of the Balbuddin was Qutbuddin Mubarak. Qutbuddin Mubarak was the successor of the Balbuddin, and his own wazir. Do you know what do you mean by wazir? The minister of the Qutbuddin Mubarak murdered him, and the slave dynasty came to an end. So here, with the Balbar, the slave dynasty has been ended. Now, the next dynasty which has started, that is the Khilji dynasty. Who started this Khilji dynasty? Jalaluddin established the Khilji dynasty. He is a man of mercy and soft-spoken kind of a person. And later on, as a result, some of his provincial officers, what they did, they became very strong, and they tried to kill him. Whom they tried to kill him? They tried to kill the Jalaluddin. Later what happened? Alauddin Khilji himself only killed the Jalaluddin, and he became the Sultan of the Delhi. So this is about the Khilji dynasty. This Khilji dynasty was established by the Jalaluddin, and Jalaluddin was killed by the Alauddin. Now Alauddin Khilji, he grew up under the protection of the Jalaluddin during his childhood days. So under whom? Under his uncle. Who is this Jalaluddin? Jalaluddin is the uncle of the Alauddin. Alauddin is the nephew of the Jalaluddin. So when his childhood itself only, Jalaluddin used to take care of the Alauddin. Each and every training, the education, whatever a warrior quality should have, those and all were given by the Jalaluddin only to the Alauddin. So Alauddin only, what he did? He murdered his uncle Jalaluddin, and he became the Sultan of the Delhi. How he became the Sultan of the Delhi, we see now. That is Jalaluddin Khilji. I already said you, he grew up under the protection of the Jalaluddin during his childhood. He was a warrior and also a governor, and also he served as a warrior, served as a governor, and also a military general. And he invaded, that is Malwa, Bilwa, Devagiri, and looted wealth. Who? Alauddin. And he stopped the attack of the Mongolians. Who stopped the attack of the Mongolians? Alauddin stopped the attack of the Mongolians. Not only that, he defeated the Rajput kings, that is Karanadeva II of Vengala dynasty, and Hemaradeva of Ranathambori, and Bheem Singh of Chittor. So apart from this, and what he did after invading the Malwa, Bilwa, Devagiri, and looted his health, what he did? He killed his guide, his mentor, that is Jalaluddin. The guide, Jalaluddin used to suggest him, give the advice. His mentor means what? The one who gives suggestion. Suggestion means to guide him. So Alauddin himself killed the Jalaluddin, and thus traded the path of murder. By murdering Alauddin, what he did? He became the Sultan of Delhi. Whom he murdered? He murdered his own uncle, that is Jalaluddin, and he crossed the path of the murder by killing Jalaluddin. Alauddin Khilji has become the Sultan of the Delhi. And what he did? Not only that, he defeated the Karanadeva, Rajput kings, Karanadeva of Vengala dynasty, and Hemaradeva Ranathambori, and Bheem Singh of Chittor. Apart from this, what he did? He conquered, that is Malwa, Jalori, Bundi, and Tom. the invasions. Who did the invasions in the South India? That is, that invasions goes to the Malik Kafur during the time of the Alauddin. So this Jalaluddin, Malik Kafur, what he did? He defeated the Madurai, Barasamudra, Warangal, and Devagiri, and looted. Just what they used to do? They used to come, they used to attack them, they used to destroy each and everything, and they loot and they go away. And they conquered and they extend their areas. So whatever the states and all he conquered, but he did combine those states. Combine is nothing but they did combine into their states and they did extend their kingdom. So who? Malik Kafur. Malik Kafur, he defeated. What he did? He defeated the Devagiri, Warangal, Dwarasamudra, and Madurai, and looted and just simply they steal the goods and all. And but whatever the conquered states and all are there, they didn't combine in their in his states and all. So after Malik Kafur, his third son became the successor. Who is his third son? That is na Qutbuddin Mubarak. He became the successor and he was murdered by his soldier, that is na Khusro. Qutbuddin Mubarak murdered by his soldier, that is na Khusro, and Khusro also murdered by, that is na Ghiyas Malik. Till after killing the Khusro, Ghiyas Malik, what he did? He established the Tughlaq dynasty. So with the Balban, the slave dynasty has been ended. With the Qutbuddin Mubarak, the Khilji dynasty has been ended, and the Tughlaq dynasty has been established. So these are all about the slave dynasty, Khilji dynasties and all. So next, in the next class, I'm going to start with the Alauddin Khilji's, that is an reforms are there. That is, three reforms are there: administrative reforms, military reforms, and the revenue reforms. After that, I'm going to start with the Tughlaq dynasty. And one more thing, students, very important thing, that I have given the notes of the Christianity and the Islam. So on May 30, I have published a video. I have uploaded a video. For that video, I have attached the notes. Notes of the Christianity and Islam notes. May 30. Better please just search the May 30, a week ago, May 30 of my video, and you will get the notes of the Christianity and Islam. And in the next video, I will tell you all how to take down the notes. So you may download it, or from there only you can take down the notes and all. You can save to your gallery. So in the next class, I am going to start with the reforms of the Alauddin Khilji. So far, I hope so you all understood my lesson. And please children, just a week ago, I have been uploaded a video of the Christianity and Islam. For that Christianity and Islam video, I have attached the notes. Start writing the notes of the Christianity and Islam. Thank you, students.